Both tellurium and polonium are highly toxic elements, and therefore their uses are limited if we compare with their congeners of the group. In addition, all known isotopes of polonium are radioactive, and therefore the application of the element are all related with its radioactivity. But let's start our discussion with tellurium, which is an element that is mainly used as an halogen additive in steel to improve its machinability, being found in lower amounts because higher content of tellurium results in hot shortness of steel. Interestingly, hot cracking is clearly also aggravated when nickel is also present in steel, because they form very low melting fields on nickel telluride. And for that reason, stainless steels usually doesn't contain tellurium, being selenium-nickel alloy the usual combination. Tellurium can be added to the steels in the form of manganese telluride. We also improve corrosion resistance, or in combination with lead, principally as lead telluride, which enhances the action of lead in the steel. Tellurium has been also used as an alloying element with other metals, such as copper, to improve its machinability without reducing its conductivity, with lead improving its strength and durability, or with cast iron, where it can act as an extremely potent carbide stabilizer. Another important application of tellurium, especially in the United States, is in the production of cadmium tellurium-based solar panels due to its semiconductor properties. Although these panels are less efficient than traditional silicon models, the technology based on cadmium telluride is growing rapidly and in asset terms, and currently represents the second most utilized solar cells, mainly due to its high absorptive capacity and economical manufacturing process. Additionally, some tellurium combinations, such as bismuth telluride and lead telluride, find important uses in the electronic and thermoelectric fields. Bismuth telluride has been found to have the best performance and is mainly used for most current thermoelectric coolers. These devices are employed in many small-scale cooling applications, including portable coolers, cooling electronic components, car seats, telecommunication laser, and satellite application. Some other tellurium compounds find some use as catalysts in organic chemistry, such as in the vulcanization of the rubber. Finally, it's interesting to note the use of a ternary alloy of the type selenium tellurium antimony and tellurium germanium antimony in the manufacture of certain compact discs. With respect to polonium, it should be noted that it's an almost pure alpha emitter with a very short life of 138.38 days. Consequently, this causes a tremendous emission of energy, and therefore it must be handled with extreme care and kept under strict control. However, this big energy output can be exploited, and the element can be used as a convenient heat source. For example, it will be possible to reach a temperature above 500 Celsius degree by sealing a metal capsule containing only half a gram of polonium. So polonium is employed to power thermoelectric generators for space satellites and lunar station. A strange use of polonium is to eliminate static charge in textile mills, paper rolls, sheet plastics, or in photographic plates to remove accumulated dust. Polonium ionizes air molecules with neutralized charge on the nearby surface. Polonium also finds a use as a neutron generator when it's combined with low atomic weight element, mainly beryllium. This polonium-beryllium couple has been employed in early nuclear weapons as part of the Manhattan Project. This has been one of the undesirable use of polonium for human beings, together with its use as a poison. Due to its dangerous nature, once polonium is absorbed into the blood, it is rapidly distributed and mainly deposited in soft tissues, principally in the liver, bone marrow, kidney and spleen. The maximum safe body burden is only 7 picograms. Polonium was the poison employed in the death of Russian spy Alexander Litvinenko, which apparently received a dose of about 10 micrograms. Unfortunately, the danger of polonium is present in our daily life, because tobacco smoke from cigarettes contains a small amount of polonium 210, and smokers receive a great amount of radiation every day. So maybe next time you light a cigarette, you can think over the dangerousness of polonium and the problem it can be causing to your organism. And maybe that could be a good reason for you to quit the habit.